we're gonna play a little game.
A game?
I'm listening.
It's time for you to play during the halftime show. Step up to the drum line. Pay attention as the drummers play a short beat. Then, try to repeat it exactly the same. You can clap your hands or tap out the beat on a table or your body. Okay, your turn. Repeat the beat. Not super easy, but you were probably close. Okay, drum pros, here's a new one. Now it's your turn. Okay, now that was a challenge, right? Chances are you'd need a little more practice before you nailed it. So, here's the question. How many of you will be motivated to rewind the show and keep trying until you get it? A few of you might, but most of you are probably like,
pass.
After all, what's the point of clapping out this beat? But what if I said if you record a video of yourself perfectly clapping or tapping this exact beat and text it to the number on the screen, you'll get a chance to win $1,000. So, are you thinking about going back and practicing now?
Well, maybe not all of you, but a lot more than before.
So, what changed? Well, duh, we offered you a chance to win money, otherwise known as an incentive. And incentives play a big part in motivation. To explain, here's Allie.
When it comes to getting motivated, most experts agree on the drive theory of motivation. So in other words, you're driven by your needs. I mean, after all, why would prehistoric humans ever leave the safety of their caves unless they were motivated by basic survival needs like food, water, and clothing? Today, you're motivated by things like money, maybe getting a good grade in history class, acceptance by your peers, or even winning the big game. Basically, anything that drives you to do something can be seen by your brain as a motivator.